Hey everybody, hope you guys are healthy and safe. So I am in a suburb of San Francisco right now, where I just got dropped off at the train station because I have to go into San Francisco. But once I get into San Francisco, I won't have a car to get around. I can rent an electric scooter there, but those things add up in price really fast. So luckily, I have this. This is the new Xiaomi Electric Scooter 4 Pro. And I will be taking this with me today on a day out in San Francisco. So the good thing about the Xiaomi Electric 4 Pro is it improves over the last generation, the 3, in that it's a little bit taller, the wheels are a little bit larger, but at the same time, the scooter is still very lightweight. This thing weighs only 17 kg, which is about 37 pounds. So as you can see, I can hand carry this up an escalator without any issues.
This is a red line train to Richmond.
Okay, so I'm in the Mission District of San Francisco. I'm gonna ride down to Hayden Ashbury where I can get a coffee. So let's look at the hardware a little bit more. So there's a switch here, a button that turns on the OLED display. As you see, it's a large OLED screen. And this button, there's only one button here that allows you to toggle through everything. So you can press it once to turn on the light in front of you. I won't need the light right now, so I'll turn it back off. And you double tap to cycle through the different modes. So as I said, at the highest setting, which is S, you can go up to 15.5 miles per hour. You have a throttle here, just press down to accelerate. You have a bell here, and this is also the hook that hooks onto the back of the scooter. These handlebars have a nice rubber grip on it, and it's quite long. Look at it, my entire fist is grabbing it, and there's still a little bit of room to spare. Now this mechanism which locks the handlebar in place is really secure. You see, it does not wobble, but at the same time, it's very fast to unfold, to unlock. So there's a little switch here. You just press up and then pull. And pulling once doesn't unlock. You have to pull down a little bit more before the handlebar comes down. So it's like a foolproof way. You're not gonna accidentally unlock this handlebar, and to lock it back in place, you just press it in and press, and then you'll hear an audible click. Once it is in place, it's super sturdy. There's a pair of disc brakes here, and whenever you pull the brake, the rear light also flashes. So check out how quiet the motor is. You don't really hear the motor at all because it's a 700 watt brushless motor. And also I'm riding through some, again, uneven terrain, and the ride is smooth. Oh shit, okay. Okay, I don't know if you just saw, but you see there's a pretty big gap here that I just rode through. Although it was a little bit bumpy, but you notice the scooter ran over fine because of these large 10-inch tires. So I'm quite lucky. I think on a scooter with a smaller wheel, I would have flipped over. But yeah, the US is the wealthiest nation on earth. San Francisco is one of the wealthiest cities on earth. We pay all these damn taxes, and what do we get? Shit like this. Okay, so up there is gonna be a good test because that's a slight hill. And this scooter, I believe, can go up to 20 degree incline. I think that's a little bit higher than 20 degree though, so I'm not sure if the scooter can make it all the way up, but we shall see. It's also worth noting that I'm a little bit heavy. I'm like 195 pounds, and I'm carrying a backpack on me that's like another 5 or 6 pounds. So it's like 200 pounds right here. The max load for the scooter is 220 pounds. Okay, gonna go up the hill. Okay, so far so good. The motor is still accelerating, but I can see it slowing down now. So I'm still going 14 kilometers per hour. I'm also going against traffic, which is bad. Oh, it's actually okay. The scooter is still going. It's going quite slow now, but at least it is indeed carrying me uphill. Okay, I don't know if you've seen the show Full House, the American TV show, but these houses here look like where the Tanners live. I mean, I'm not sure. I don't know if it is, but it kind of looks like it. It's on a hill, and then you have a park right across the street. Now, because this is a Xiaomi product, there is a companion app that you can pair to, and you get some smart features. So it's the Xiaomi Mi Home app. I've already paired a scooter. In here, see, it connects via Bluetooth, and in here you can do a bunch of stuff like lock the motor, leave the tail light always on, so meaning it doesn't have to just turn on when you pull the brake. You can enable cruise control with this enabled, so that means when you press down the throttle for more than 5 seconds, it will lock into that speed and keep going. Okay, so I am on Haight and Ashbury right now. So this is supposedly one of the trendiest hipster districts of San Francisco. I thought it would be a lot more lively, but right now it's really quiet. I mean, granted, it is a Wednesday morning, but still. But anyway, let's check battery life. So far I've ridden about 4 miles, I want to say. I rode 2 miles in San Francisco so far. Plus I used this yesterday in the suburbs for another 2 miles. And right now it has lost about 1 bar. There's 5 bars total, we're down to 4 bars. So going by my very unscientific math, this scooter should last about 20 miles. This is about on par with what Xiaomi advertises, actually. Okay, so the scooter handles very well. The handlebar is very responsive. Watch me navigate through some tight corners right here. Okay, so it is now 5:30. I've been riding all day, starting at like 8 a.m. Obviously not non-stop, but you know, I rode all throughout San Francisco, and right now I still have like 2 bars of battery. So I think the battery life here is good enough to last you an entire day. So overall, I really like the Xiaomi Scooter 4 Pro. I think it's really good for someone like me who, I don't want to live a lifestyle where I have to drive everywhere. I want to walk, take public transport if possible, and then if not possible, hop on a scooter. So like I said, there are plenty of electric scooters in San Francisco, but they can get pricey, and as you can see, people trash them pretty badly. So it's just better to have your own. This thing is highly portable, easy to maneuver. The only shortcomings, nitpicks I have with the scooter is that, number one, I think the cables, the wires, they flare out a little bit too much. I worry that it's gonna get hooked onto something when I'm riding. The second is probably the price. The Xiaomi Scooter 4 Pro retails for around $730 US. I personally think that's a reasonable price for a transportation machine, but there are scooters you can find on Amazon for like 300, 400 bucks, and they will do the same thing, except the shock absorption will not be as good, it will not go up incline as well, and probably it won't be as smooth as a ride. But you know, a lot of people are okay with that. And if you can afford to pay a little bit more, you get what you pay for. So that's about it for this video. This is probably my last video of 2022, so Happy New Year's, and I'll be back in 2023 with a lot of new content, including all the newest smartphones that comes out like in January. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching.